Good morning, my dear kids. Hope you all are enjoying your classes and staying safe at home. Today, again, I am here with lesson number 8, grammar, which is pronoun. So, at first, we will revise what is a pronoun. The definition of the pronoun is, pronoun are the words used in place of nouns. Examples are, I, he, she, it, we, you, etc. Okay, now let's move to the questions. Your first question is, complete these conversations with suitable pronoun. Here in this question, I will show you the conversation between two peoples, which are you and me. And what you have to do, you have to fill the blanks with suitable pronouns. Okay, the first conversation is, here A means me and B means you. Okay, the first one is, have dash seen my notebook. Here I am asking a question to you that have dash seen your notebook. So which pronoun I will use to complete this sentence? Yes, I will use you. So the sentence is, have you seen my notebook? So now in reply, what you will answer? You will answer here, yes, dash is on the desk. Here we are talking about the notebook. So for notebook, which pronoun we will use? Yes, we will use it. And the sentence is, yes, it is on the desk. Okay, the second conversation is, A, where are the children going? Here I am asking a question that, where are the children going? Now you are answering it, dash are going to park, dash am also going with dash. Here we are talking about the children, so at first we will use, in first blank, which pronoun we will use? We will use they, because here in this place we are using they as a subject of the sentence. Okay, so and next sentence, in next blank, what we will do here? You can see am is there, so it's obvious we will use I here. And in the last blank, we need the object of the sentence, so we are talking about children, so what will be the answer? The answer will be them. Them is here because we need object of the sentence. And the final answer is, they are going to park, I am also going with them. Okay, the third one is your father at home? Now you will answer, no, dash has gone to the market, mom has gone with dash, dash will be coming back soon. Here we are talking about the father. So in our first blank, which pronoun we will use? Yes, we will use he, because here we need the subject of the sentence. That's why we use he here. And in the next blank, what we will need? We need object of the sentence. So which pronoun we will use for father? We will use him here. And in our next blank, we need again the subject of the sentence. So the pronoun will be he. And the final answer is, no, he has gone to the market, mom has gone with him, he will be coming back soon. The next one is, do dash like axe? Here I am again asking a question to you. So here in the blank, I will fill which pronoun? Yes, we will fill you here. And the question is, do you like eggs? Now in return, what you will answer? No, dash don't, dash smells strange. Now here we are talking about eggs. So in first blank, which pronoun we will use? We will use I, because here you are answering it. So you will say, no, I don't. And in next blank, you are talking about eggs. So eggs is a thing. So which pronoun you will use? You will use it here. And the answer is, no, I don't, it smells strange. The next one is, will dash read the storybook for dash? Here, I am asking a question to you, and in first blank, which pronoun I will use? I will use you here because I am talking to you, and in next blank, the pronoun we will use is me. And the answer is, will you read this storybook for me? Now, in answer, what you will give? Yes, give dash to dash. I love stories. Here in first blank, we are talking about the books. So that's why we will use it pronoun. And in next blank, we are talking about you. So what you will use here? You will use me. So the final answer is, yes, give it to me. I love stories. Your next question is, replace the underlined words with suitable pronouns and rewrite the sentences. Here, what you have to do, you have to change the underlined words with suitable pronouns and you have to rewrite the sentences. The first sentence is, Sumit drives an old car. Sumit cleans the car himself. Here you can see the underlined word is Sumit and the car. Here Sumit is a noun, so, and he is a boy. So which pronoun we will use? We will use he for Sumit, and in the second word is the car. Here we are talking about the car. The car is an object, so we will use it as a pronoun. So the answer is, Sumit drives an old car, he cleans it himself. The next sentence is, I like broccoli and capsicum in soup. Broccoli and capsicum give a distinct taste to soup. Here the underlined words are broccoli and capsicum and soup. So in first underlined word we are talking about broccoli and capsicum. They are pronouns, so we will use which pronoun here? We will use they. And in next underlined word is soup, so we will use it pronoun with soup, because here we want object of the sentence and soup is an object, so we will use it. So the answer is, I like broccoli and capsicum in soup. They will give a distinct taste to it. Next question is, Manu and Mani are cousins. Manu and Mani live in Chennai. We miss Manu and Mani. Here, in both the places, the underlined words are Manu and Mani, but you can see in first sentence, the Manu and Mani is a subject of the sentence, and in second, Manu and Mani are the object of the sentence. So, at first, what we will do? We will change Manu and Mani in first place with pronoun they, and in next, what we will use? We will use them as a pronoun, because in last sentence, the Manu and Mani are the object of this sentence. And the final answer is, Manu and Mani are cousins. They live in Chennai. We miss them. The next statement is, where is Jenny? Jenny is the monitor of our class. We are looking for Jenny. Here in first place, again you can see Jenny is the subject of the sentence, and in next, Jenny is the object of the sentence. So similarly, we will change Jenny with pronoun. In first, we will use she, and in second, we will use her as a pronoun for Jenny. So the final answer is, where is Jenny? She is the monitor of our class. We are looking for her. In your next sentence, the sentence is, Karthik is writing a letter to his granny. Karthik loves his granny. Here, the first word is Karthik and the second word is his granny. Karthik is the subject of the sentence and his granny is the object of the sentence. So Karthik is a boy, so which pronoun we will use? We will use he here, and the next one is his granny. Here we are talking about his granny, the second person, so we will use her, because here his granny is a object of the sentence. And the final answer is, Kartik is writing a letter to his granny. He loves her. Next question is, cross the wrong pronouns. Here I will show you some sentences with two pronouns, and what you have to do, you have to put cross in wrong pronouns. So the first statement is, your bag is too heavy. How are you carrying it or them? So here we are talking about bag. So we will use which pronoun for bag? Yes, we will use it for bag. So the wrong pronoun is them. We will put cross. The next statement is, Joy and Roy are playing. I am also playing with him or them. Here you can see we are talking about two persons, Joy and Roy. So they become plural. So for plural, we will use them as a pronoun. So the wrong pronoun is him. The final answer is, Joy and Roy are playing. I am also playing with them. The next one is, this is my mobile phone. My mom gifted it or her to me. Here you can see in this sentence we are talking about mobile phone, so it is an object. So which pronoun we will use for this? Yes, we will use it as a pronoun. So the wrong pronoun is her. And the final answer is, this is my mobile phone. My mom gifted it to me. The next one is, we slash us are playing. Here you can see in this sentence we are talking about the people, we. So, and the pronoun is the subject of the sentence, so we will use we here, and the wrong pronoun is us. And the final answer is, we are playing. And the last one is, Sudha is a news reader. We like she or her. Here you can see we are talking about Sudha, and the pronouns are she and her, and they are object of the sentence. So which pronoun we will use? Yes, we will use her, and the wrong pronoun is she. The final statement is, Sudha is a news reader. We like her. This is it for today. Thank you so much for watching it. Bye-bye. Take care.